Pit stops were a feature of the racing here. This is the home banking at Brookland. It's part of the old circuit, and it's now officially classified as an ancient monument. Brookland was built for £150,000. In 1907, that would have paid for 2,000 navvies, with their steam shovels and their concrete mixers, for 18 whole months. Today, it would just buy you a few cars. This lineup alone is worth nearly £70,000, but they're cars in a special part of the market. Out of every 8 cars sold in Britain, one belongs to what you can call the executive class, cars from around £4,500 upwards. But high prices mean high profits for the car makers, so it's a competitive class, with plenty that's new round motor fair time. This is the new Granada, what the trade calls a reskin. Underneath, it's very much like the old Granada, but lighter, with some new V6 engine options, a new refinement that takes it close to BMW and Mercedes for luxury. Ford have had their eye on upmarket standards of quietness and smooth ride for years, and with this car they've done it. This is the Gear 2.8, 100 miles an hour, 21 to the gallon. But for the money, doesn't it look just a little bit too much like a big Cortina? Further down the range, of course, you won't get so much sound damping, but you'll get 24 to the gallon. The 2.3 GL is not so fast either, and for the first time, Ford will have a diesel version. It'll use the 2.1-litre Peugeot engine, not the new 2.3-litre, because Peugeot didn't tell Ford it was up their sleeve. The question is, will the new Granadas at those higher prices still vie with the Leyland Princess in the sales charts? So far this year, they're running neck and neck. The Opel record, like the Granada, was 5 years old, so it too got a facelift, and Opel stylists came to much the same conclusions as Ford's. Resemblances include the front and those big plastic strips along the sides. But this is a 2-litre only, and it won't be sold here until next February. Prices still to be decided. Expected here in the middle of next month, the Audi Avant. It's the back where it differs from the usual 5-cylinder Audi 100. They've grafted on the hatchback from the Volkswagen Passat, and the price, under £5,000. This must be one of the liveliest Cortinas ever. It's also one of the most expensive, but enthusiasts are already forming a queue. It's got the 2.3-litre German V6, but also goes into the new Granadas, making this not only one of the fastest, but also one of the most refined of all Cortinas. Rover practically invented the executive car. Quiet, well-made, a little more expensive, but above all, tasteful. At one time, indeed, it seemed as if they were all taste and no go, but that's all changed now, because Leyland have widened the Rover range and added these two new 6-cylinder models to the existing 3500. These are the 2200 and the 2600, with new overhead camshaft 6-cylinder engines instead of the big V8. All the traditional armchair comfort of the interior remains. The fascia is simpler on the 2200, but the body shell is just the same. Indeed, they're very difficult to tell apart. Inevitably, the Japanese are not neglecting the market. Datsun are to offer the executive class this Laurel 6. It's a 2-litre 6-cylinder with, as we've come to expect from the Japanese, a big range of standard equipment, including radio, stereo with automatic tape reversal, a hand lamp in the toolkit, and this little light, which shows you when you're not driving economically. Here's another preview, the Lancia Gamma. It won't be with us until next March, and then it's going to cost around £7,000. It's one of the few cars in the class with a 4-cylinder engine. Also from Turin, from the Fiat Lancia group, is the new Fiat 132, with 2 litres instead of the 1600 or 1800 engines. Now, this used to be rather an ungainly car. It had heavy steering, it wasn't very fast, and it was rather less of a driver's car than the rest of the Fiat range. So they've made a big effort with power steering and lots of detail improvements to compete in this class where the opposition is so keen. How the executives are wooed by Europe's motor industry. But so are their bosses, and this is the car they could be buying. It's the new BMW 733i. And this isn't even the top of the BMW range. There's a coupe version of this at getting on for £15,000. And if you've got one of those, you've really made it.